When we build traditional software systems, we're architects of certainty. Each component, each function, precise instruction following an exact path, reliability through predictability. Giving the same input, we expect the same output every single time. But what if we could explore the best in all paths? Working with code is working with, say, Newton's law. Predictable, measurable, and deterministic. Whereas AI components follow quantum principles, probabilistic, contextual, and sometimes surprising. Let's start with the foundation. Large language models, or LLMs, these are the engines behind AI systems today. Instead of following explicit instructions, an LLM predicts what output should come next based on patterns and data. It is not executing if-else statements or for loops. It calculates probabilities across billions of parameters. Where our code would crash on unexpected inputs, LLM gracefully handles ambiguity. Where we would write explicit rules for each scenario, LLM learns patterns from examples. In other words, in traditional software, we might build an expert system with thousands of explicit rules hand-coded. If this symptom and that symptom, then deliver this diagnosis. LLM learns relationships from data, delivering a more nuanced that no rule system ever could. Now, they're less like expert systems and more like experts themselves. Most of you have worked with traditional workflows. They're the backbone of reliable software. Input goes in, predictable output comes out. In traditional development, workflows are deterministic by design. They follow explicit rules in a predetermined sequence. It's A, then B, then C, always. Think of your API call, database operations, or your typical business logic. So we build ETA pipelines to extract data, transform it in specific ways, and load it where it needs to go. Now, what happens when we add an LLM into this workflow? This is probably the workflow you most likely interacted with.
Have you ever had a dream that...
This is a workflow that uses AI to create content and produce it. Now, the key difference is that it's probably non-deterministic. So that means that the same input might produce different, but still relevant, output each time. Think of your ETL pipelines or your data processing workflows. It's predetermined steps in a fixed sequence. Now, GenAI workflows are more like creative production lines. The stages might be the same, so input, process, output, but the process might have an artistic license. Taking it one step further, if we allowed AI to guide our workflow execution based on our inputs, those are called agentic workflows. Like GenAI workflows, these are also non-deterministic. What we are used to are building orchestrated systems like Airflow or Prefect, which coordinate complex sequences of tasks. The orchestrator has a predetermined map they follow, and if this task fails, then try this fallback. If it succeeds, then try this other thing. For agentic workflow, the script is flipped.
Have you ever had a dream that you...
The AI becomes the orchestrator, deciding which tools and functions to use based on the specific input and goals. Think of them as less of a fixed score and more of like jazz improvisation. The melody is always going to be recognizable, but the sequence and how it's organized is created in the moment. Let's be clear about something. Agentic workflows are AI orchestrating predefined sets of tools and functions. It selects how they're organized and what sequence and which one to use within the boundaries that we've established. So again, it is about AI having flexibility of how they build this workflow specifically, but still within the frameworks we have written out for them. We finally reach agents. In traditional architecture, we build microservices, which are independent components that handle specific functions. Now, these communicate through well-defined interfaces and are able to follow predetermined logic. Agents take this even further with their autonomy. It is a self-contained AI system that is able to perceive its environment, make decisions, and take actions on goals. While microservices respond to very specific requests in a predictable way, But the agents take this, you know, even above and beyond because they're able to actively pursue objectives. So they're able to take a tool, learn from the results, and then adapt their approach completely, you know? Now, if I were to make a difference between both of these, I would say that the microservices are more like a specialized tool that do something really, really perfectly. And then the agents are more like a craft person that know when and how to use all the tools in their set.
Have you ever had a dream that you had?
Now, obviously I have to talk about the difference so you don't get confused about agentic workflows and agents. And mainly the difference here would be autonomy and scope. When we talk about agentic workflows, we're talking about the fact that it's able to control the whole workflow execution with predetermined tools and functions, right? To complete a task. When it comes to the agent itself, it literally just tells you, hey, I need a new tool. I can look up the information by myself. I can select the approach that I want to go about this, or in general, just control the whole thing with much greater independence. Now, obviously we have to be mindful and think that in the end, when it comes to traditional architecture, even all the way down to like agents, we're not talking about replacing one another. We're talking about a collaboration that can strengthen them, right? Because at the end of the day, most of the systems won't be purely deterministic or purely AI driven. It'll be a combination of both that can be thoughtful and really, you know, hold itself with each other's strength.